गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लुकिंग इनटू द सेकंड थ्योरम इन अवर स्टडी, दैट इज थेवेनिन्स थ्योरम। लाइक आई एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द प्रीवियस सेशन दैट दीज थ्योरम्स आर यूज्ड एक्सटेंसिवली टू सिंप्लीफाई द सर्किट एनालिसिस एंड रिड्यूस द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ द सर्किट एनालिसिस एंड ऑल्सो ऑब्टेन द इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट्स the which can be derived from the complex circuit that is been given for analysis, and these equivalent circuits are obtained with a very simple connections and with minimum number of elements present in them. Okay, so Thevenin theorem is one such theorem that will give us a very simple equivalent circuit, okay, with only three elements in it, three series connected elements in it, however complex the actual circuit may be. Okay, so first we'll look into what is the statement of Thevenin's theorem. We'll start with the statement. I have already written this statement on the screen. Okay, so I'll just read out and we'll see the meaning of that. Then we'll look into the example solution using or applying the Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so Thevenin's theorem statement goes like this: any bilateral network, however complicated it may be, connected to a load impedance, can be replaced by a simple equivalent circuit containing a voltage source and an impedance in series with it. So the first statement says that however complicated the circuit may be, if I am interested in any one element to know the behavior of it or to get the current or voltage across it, that element I consider it as load impedance or load resistance or load element. Okay, so to any connected load in element in the circuit, okay, in any complicated bilateral network, okay, that complicated bilateral network can be replaced by a very simple equivalent circuit, okay, which contains only the source, series impedance, and the load impedance. So this is the meaning of the statement. Okay, and the voltage, what should be the voltage source? Suppose if there are multiple voltage sources in the circuit, that entire circuit will get replaced to a circuit having only one source. So that voltage source should be equivalent voltage source. So the voltage source is equal to the open circuit voltage across the load terminals. Okay, now if I open the load terminal, we will see the procedure in the forthcoming slide or forthcoming incoming time. There you'll understand exactly what I'm intended to tell in this statement. The voltage of the simple circuit, the voltage source of the equivalent circuit, is equal to the open circuit voltage across the load terminals. That is, I have to pick out the load and keep the load terminal open, then I should measure what is the voltage source, sorry, what is the voltage value. So that is open circuit voltage across load terminal, that is the source value of the equivalent circuit. Okay, and impedance is equivalent impedance of the circuit as seen from the load terminals. Okay, if I keep the load terminal open and look into the circuit from the load terminal point of view, then whatever the equivalent impedance I get, that is the equivalent impedance of the equivalent circuit. Okay, and how to get the resistance or impedance? I should be deactivating all the sources. That is, deactivate voltage source by replacing it with short circuit or internal impedance, and deactivate current sources by keeping them open circuit. So this is the statement of Thevenin's theorem. We will look theoretically what does it mean. Okay, now suppose I have a complex circuit. Let this be a bilateral network bilateral. Complex network. Complex in the sense not containing the J term, that complex we don't mean here. Complex in the sense complicated, okay, more complicated circuit, which is not simple. Now, if this bilateral complex network is connected with a load impedance, now let us take a load impedance. Okay. So, to this terminal, there is a load impedance connected. Okay. Let me name that load terminals as A and B. And this is the load impedance ZL. Now, anything that is connected to this load impedance is a bilateral network. The entire complex circuitry, whatever we get, that is a bilateral complex bilateral network. Now, this complex bilateral network can be replaced with a very simple network. Okay, with a very simple network, I will replace it. Okay. I will replace, and that simple network contains a voltage source. A series impedance. I will keep the load impedance. This is load terminal A and load terminal B. Okay. So this is plus, minus, this is equivalent impedance, and this is open circuit voltage. I will represent it as ETH, Thevenin's voltage. Okay. Now I can find out very conveniently the current flowing in this load. This is ZL. Okay. This is ZL. So whatever may be the complex circuit, okay, it can be represented using a very simple series circuit. Say, for example, I will take it here. The circuit may be anything. You can consider any complex circuit. Anything I can consider. Okay. Now, if the load resistance is this, if this is RL, then however complex, you can observe the circuit is very much complex here. Okay, the circuit is very much complex. You can observe, I will simply represent this keeping RL as it is. Okay, I will take one series because all the components are resistances. I will take R equivalent, and there is an equivalent voltage source VTH. Okay, so this is my RL, and I want to know what is the current in RL here. I want to know what is the load current. Very simply, I can find out what is the load current IL. Okay, because now I can give IL is equals to, okay, simple, VTH by R equivalent plus RL. Okay, R equivalent plus RL, that's it. Now if I don't want to apply Thevenin theorem and find the value of IL, now observe there are six meshes present and number of nodes present. So if you go with mesh current analysis, you have to solve six mesh current equations. Okay, six equations you have to solve, then I will get the value of IL in this load resistor. Okay, if you want to go for node voltage analysis, see there are so many nodes present here. Okay, many nodes present here. So we have to find out the node voltages, then accordingly find out what is the current flowing through the RL. So that is a complex process. That is a time-consuming process. Okay. So Thevenin theorem will give us the tool. Okay. Thevenin theorem is a tool with which I can convert a complex circuit to a very simple circuit. So this was the circuit what I intended to solve. But when I applied Thevenin theorem to this, very easily I got a circuit. I got a circuit through which I can find out the current in RL, okay, very conveniently. But one thing what we have to observe here is, if I want to find out current in this RL, let me take this RL1. Suppose I want to find out the current in this resistor also, let me take this RL2. I want to find the current in this resistor also, let me take this as RL3. Then the thing is, I should be applying Thevenin's theorem individually, taking this each resistance as load resistance once at a time. So simultaneously I will not get all the currents in all the branches. I will be getting a current in an intended element which I consider to be a load element. So that is one difficulty we face. Directly we won't get the currents in all the branches. If I want to go for all the currents I want, then the fundamental analysis, either mesh analysis or node voltage analysis, I have to take it. Okay, so this is the fundamental understanding of the statement of Thevenin theorem. Okay, this is the statement of Thevenin theorem. Okay, now we will look into how exactly I have to solve this, because I told in the statement that a complex network, a complex connection of elements has to be replaced by a simple series circuit, but there should be some method with which I can get this simple series circuit. Okay, so there is a small procedure. Okay, there is a small procedure to be followed if I want to apply Thevenin theorem, okay, in my analysis. Okay, so that I have to find out. So this is the procedure. Okay, this is the procedure what I have to follow in applying the Thevenin's theorem. Now, step by step, I will show what has to be done. Now, let me take a simple circuit. Not so simple circuit. Let me consider. Procedure to apply Thevenin's theorem. I will take one circuit. this way V1, V2, let this be current I, okay, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, R8, and I will take a load resistor. Okay, this is my load terminal A and load terminal B. Take this up. Now I want the current in R. I want to find. Okay. I want to find the current in RL, that is IL, load current. Now to this circuit, I have to apply the Thevenin's theorem. Now, as per the steps, what we have to follow. First step. Now, I wanted to find the current in load. So first step is to keep the load terminals open. So open the load resistor. Okay. So I have to open the load resistor here. What I will do, I will just open this. I will open it and momentarily I will keep it aside. We will see. Okay. I will keep this aside. Okay. So now, first I have to open the load terminals and keep that aside. So now, what is the second step? Calculate or measure the open circuit voltage. This is Thevenin's voltage. Now, this is the open circuit formed here. Okay. Now, I should find what is the voltage across, okay, this open circuit. Let this be A and B. What is the voltage across this open circuit? Now to find this voltage across open circuit, you can use any method. You can use mesh current analysis, you can use node voltage analysis, or if the circuit is simply, we can solve it by direct application of Ohm's law also, by circuit reduction or by source transformation. Anything you can use, okay, anything you can use, but you should remember that the process followed must be correct, so that with any method you use, the voltage value VTH should come same. So find out the value of voltage VTH by using any method you like, you feel easy. So find out the value of VTH. So now I will be writing VTH is equals to some volts. Okay. I got the value of VTH is equal to, so this is called VTH is Thevenin's equivalent voltage. So VTH is Thevenin's equivalent voltage, or it is also known as open circuit voltage. Because I have found out this VTH at open circuit condition of the load terminals, it is also known as open circuit voltage. Okay. So this is Thevenin's equivalent voltage. This is one point what we have to follow. Second, next. After that, once I find out what is the Thevenin's voltage, I found out this voltage, then open current source and short voltage source. Now I have to find out. I have to find out this equivalent resistance. R equivalent I need to find out now. Okay. So because I have to find out this R equivalent, I have to short circuit the voltage source and open circuit the current. So that is simply deactivate the sources present in the circuit. That's it. That is the meaning. Deactivate the sources present in the circuit. Now when I deactivate the sources present in the circuit, I will get a new circuit. Okay, I will redraw here down. Now next step is to short voltage source. I will take a different color. Short voltage source. And open current source. And open current source. Okay, so I will redraw this circuit. By doing so, I have to short voltage source. So V1 will get this. V1 will get shorted. Okay, R1 will remain as it is. R2 will remain as it is. See the connection. R3 will remain as it is. In this branch, only R4 will remain, whereas V2 will be short circuited. Here, this is R5, and I get R6. Okay. I have R7 and R8. So this is low terminal A, low terminal B. Now this is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6. For a moment, I will not take R8 into consideration. Let us not take R8 into consideration. We will take it as line. Okay, I don't want R8. This is R7. Okay, I have only 7 resistors. Now, by doing this, I should observe the circuit from the load terminals. This is very important. You please be careful, because generally what we see when I want to find out the equivalent circuit of any circuit, equivalent resistance or impedance of any circuit, what I do is I observe the circuit from the source terminal. I observe the circuit from the source terminal. This is generally what we do. Okay, but when we have to find out the equivalent resistance which is offering its resistance to the current flowing in this load branch, then I should be observing the circuit from the load terminals. Okay, RTH observed from load or load terminal. RTH observed from load terminal. See, when I look into the circuit from two different sides, the equivalent resistance may be different. Okay, so we can see it here. If you observe from this R1, R2 and R3, okay, if you observe from side X from X. Okay. R equivalent is equals to, see, R2 and R3 appears in parallel, which are in series with R1. So R1 plus R2 parallel R3. Now, if you observe from the end Y, from Y, R equivalent is equals to, you can see R1 and R2 appears parallel and R3 is in series with that combination. R1, sorry, R3 plus R1 parallel R2. So the equivalent resistance is not same all the time. It depends from which terminal I am observing into the circuit. And the equivalent circuit is same if the source is only one in the circuit. If the source is only one, then there is no change. Then we don't generally go with it. We generally go from the source end. But when there are multiple sources, I am observing in Thevenin's theorem from the load end. So I have to observe the circuit from the load ends. So with this, okay, with by observing the circuit from this end, what I get? R1 parallel R2 in series with R3, that is in parallel with R4, that is in series with R5, that is in parallel with R6, which is in series with R7. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit I have to find. If you observe from this end, it appears R6 parallel to R7, that is in series with R5, that is in parallel with R4, that is in series with R3, in parallel with R2, in series with R1. So resistance value change. You can give some values here and you can try. Definitely the resistance values may change. Okay. So I have to observe the circuit from the load terminals and then find out the equivalent resistance or impedance. So that becomes the equivalent series resistance RTH. Okay. That becomes the equivalent series resistance RTH. So this part I will rub out. I don't want this. Okay. Just delete this part. Okay. Now what is RTH? RTH is known as Thevenin's equivalent resistance. Okay, so I got VTH. Okay, I got VTH by finding the voltage across this open circuit terminals. I got RTH by calculating the equivalent impedance observed from the load terminals. Then I can represent this complex circuit, okay, using a simple circuit. So this is VTH, or you can call ETH, no harm. These are the load terminals A and B. See which I have taken here. I have taken it. I had kept this out. Okay. I had kept this out. Sorry, just give me a moment. Now I want to take it and simply place it. Okay, so this I simply want to place it. So whatever I have taken out, the load resistance which I had kept open earlier, now I am placing it in the circuit. Now I am placing it in the circuit and finding the value of IL. Now this is RTH. So what is IL now? IL is equals to, I can very easily write VTH divided by RTH plus RL. So I get the value of current in the load resistance in a very simple manner, in a very simple manner, by applying Thevenin's theorem. Okay, by applying Thevenin's theorem. So now, if want, we can use one example. Okay, we'll solve one example. I will take one example. Okay. I'll take one simple example and we'll solve. Okay. So I'll first draw the circuit. Volts, this be 1 amperes, 20 ohms, 10 ohms and 5 ohms. Okay, so let this be the circuit and I want to find the power dissipated in 5 ohm. Okay, find power dissipated in 5 ohm resistor. Find the power dissipated in 5 ohm resistor. Okay. So with this statement given, my 5 ohm resistor has become load. Now 5 ohm resistor has become load. So first step, what I can do is I will write here 5 ohm resistor is load. Okay, so with this, what I have to do is, okay, take out 5 ohm resistor. I will give the terminal names. Let this be A and let this be B. take out 5 ohm and create open circuit across AB. Okay, create, take 5 ohm resistor and create open circuit across AB. So with this I can draw the circuit. I will redraw the circuit. I will simply redraw the circuit here. Or else what I will do, I can, if possible, I will see. So this is the load terminal which is to be kept open, A and B. This is 10 ohm as it is, 20 ohms, a source of 1 amperes, a source of 2 amperes, 10 ohms, 10 ohms and 10 volts. Okay. So this is what the new circuit looks like by taking out the load resistor. I have open circuited the load terminals. Now I should be finding what is the voltage here, VAB. Okay, open circuit voltage, which is equals to now VTH, Thevenin's equivalent voltage. Okay, that is required. Now apply either mesh analysis or node voltage analysis. Okay, we can do anything. Now it is simple. So I would like to apply node voltage analysis because there are only two nodes. Okay, I can apply node voltage analysis here. Let this be voltage V1 and voltage V2. I will write it here. Find VAB equals to VTH using nodal analysis. See, you can use by source transformation also. You can do it by source transformation also. You can use it, do it by mesh analysis also. Any method you can use. Okay. I am choosing here node voltage analysis. Okay, so I will be doing it using node voltage analysis. So I will write apply KCL at node 1. I will apply KCL at node 1. So let this be I1. This is 2 amperes and let this be I2. Okay. Let this be I3. Now you observe here, there is a 10 ohm resistor connected. There is a 10 ohm resistor connected. This is a suspended branch in the circuit now. This 10 ohm is connected to an open circuit. So any branch that is connected to open circuit will not carry any current. So this is not a node. Please remember, this is not a node. This is same as point A. So what I can do is, I can discard the presence of 10 ohm in the circuit. There is no current flowing in this 10 ohm, okay, because this is a part of open circuit. There is, even if the current wants to flow inside this in 10 ohm, there is no return path for the flow of current. So please remember, any current entering in any element should have its return path out. Whatever may be the path it may follow, but it should have a return path. There is no return path if current flows in 10 ohm. So therefore, current will not flow in 10 ohm. Current will not flow in 10 ohm. So the current in 10 ohm is zero. Okay. So here I can mark I is equals to zero. So I need not to consider this in my KCL equation. Now at node 1, KCL at node 1. Okay. KCL at node 1. I can write I1, it is entering, minus I2, it is leaving, minus 2 amperes, okay, is equals to 0. So this I will write it as, what is I1? I1 is coming from 10 volts, 10 minus V1 by 10. I2 is from V1 to V2, so minus of V1 minus V2 by 10 and minus 2 is equals to 0. Okay. So this I will solve, I will keep the answer directly. So this gives us the equation. Okay. Minus 0.2 V1 minus 0.2 V1 plus 0.1 V2 is equals to 1. So this is equation 1. Okay, so that is equation 1. Now apply KCL at node 2. Okay, I should be applying KCL at node 2. Okay, KCL at node 2. So there I can write it as plus I2 minus 2 amperes KCL at node 2, I can write I2 is entering node 2 plus 2 amperes, because 2 amperes is entering node 2, plus 1 ampere is entering node 2, minus I3 is equals to 0. Okay, minus I3 is equal to, so what is I2? It is V1 minus V2. V1 minus V2 divided by 10 plus 2 plus 1 minus I3. It is V2 by 20. V2 minus 0 by 20. That is V2 by 20 is equals to 0. So this will give us another equation of 0.1 V1. I have a solved example of this, so I am writing directly 0.15 V2, 0.15 V2 is equals to minus 3. This is equation 2. This is equation 2. Now, on solving these two equations, okay, on solving equation 1 and 2, solving equation 1 and 2, we get V1 is equals to V1 is equal to 7.5 volts and V2 is equals to 25 volts. Both positive. Okay. Now observe, what is VTH? VAB. Now I have discarded this 10 ohm. So when there is no current flowing in 10 ohm, when there is no current flowing in 10 ohm, the drop between V2 and terminal A is 0. So it means V2 is same as that of terminal A. So therefore, VTH is nothing but equals to V2. Okay, VTH is nothing but equals to V2. So I can write here VTH is equals to 2, which is 25 volts. Now I got the value of voltage source in the equivalent circuit. So VTH is 25 volts. Now I have to find the current. So to find the current, I should be short circuiting the voltage sources and open circuiting the current sources, and observe the circuit from the load terminals. Okay, and observe the circuit through load terminals. So what I will do is I will take this circuit. Okay. I will copy this and try to paste. Yeah, I got the circuit. Okay, lower line is missing here. I will join now. I have to keep all the voltage circuit short circuited, voltage sources short circuited, and current sources open circuited. Okay. So next, here, to find RTH, keep voltage source shorted and current source open. Okay, now with that, I have to redraw the circuit. I will redraw it. Voltage source short circuited, 10 ohm as it is, another 10 ohm. So this 2 ohm current source will be open circuited. 2 amp current source is open circuited. 1 amp current source is open circuited. Terminal A, terminal B. Okay, so 10 ohm, 10 ohm, 20 ohm, and 10 ohm. Now I should be observing the circuit from the load ends. Okay, I should be observing the circuit from load ends. So from here, what I get? 10 ohm, 10 ohm are in series, which is in parallel with 20 ohm. So I will redraw this. A and B. This is 10 ohm. This is 20 ohm. And this is 20 ohm. So these two 20 ohms are in parallel, which is in series with another 10 ohm. So RTH is equals to 10 plus 20 parallel 20. Okay, so this will come out to be 10 plus 20 into 20 divided by 20 plus 20. So this is 20 ohms. So RTH is 20 ohms. So now replace the circuit using VTH and RTH. Now I have the load which is of 5 ohms. Okay, I have a series resistance which is RTH, which is 20 ohms, and I have a voltage source which is nothing but my VTH. These are load terminals A, B. VTH, okay, this is 25 volts. Okay. Now this is the circuit, equivalent circuit, Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay, so this is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay, so this Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Therefore, what is the value of current now? See, the value of current in 5 ohms is IL. So IL is equals to, okay, it is 25 divided by 20 plus 5, 1 amperes. Okay, IL is 1 amperes. But what is power dissipated in 5 ohms? I want power dissipated in 5 ohms. Power dissipated in 5 ohm. P 5 ohm is equals to, I can write IL square RL, that is 1 square into 5 is 5 watts. So this is the solution. Okay, so this is how I have to find the Thevenin's equivalent circuit using Thevenin's theorem. So what I did first in the circuit given, I kept the load open. By keeping the load open, I found out what is the open circuit voltage, that became Thevenin's voltage here. Okay, so once I got Thevenin's voltage, I wanted to find what is Thevenin's resistance. So I open circuited all the current sources and short circuited all the voltage sources and looked into the circuit from the load terminals and found out what is the equivalent value of resistance or impedance. So that I got the Thevenin's equivalent resistance. So once I get Thevenin's equivalent resistance and Thevenin's equivalent voltage, I will get Thevenin's equivalent circuit, and I can find out very conveniently by simple application of Ohm's law the value of current in the load impedance or load resistance. And I can find out power dissipation, I can find out the voltage drop, I can find out the energy consumed, whatever I want I can find out once I know the current in this load resistor. Okay. So this is about the Thevenin's theorem with an example. In the next class, I will solve one more example. Along with, we will say Norton's theorem also, because Norton's theorem is a small extension of Thevenin's theorem. That's it. Okay. We will look into that in the next session of the circuit analysis class, and we'll stop as of now. Okay. We'll end this session today. We'll meet in next session. Okay. So thank you for joining.